الرحمن الرحيم، وصلى الله على النبي الكريم محمد وآله وأصحابه أجمعين. Another prerequisite of prayer or shart, prerequisite is called shart. Little meaning of shart is condition. But keeping in view the importance of these conditions for prayer, we have used the word prerequisite. A mandatory prerequisite of prayer, another one, it is niyyat, N-I-Y-Y-A-T. N-I-Y-Y-A-T, niyyat, intention. As a preface or prelude, we will say, if as far as the case of reward is concerned, for every good or permissible deed and action, niyat is important, our intention is important. While for certain other actions that is mandatory, point number two in prelogue is that niyat for prayer, that is farz or mandatory in all schools of jurisprudence. But in Hanafi and Hanbali school, that is shart. Shart means prerequisite. In Maliki and Shafi school, that is rukun, R-U-K, N. Rukun means constituent or factor. Constituent or factor. Faraz is near all. All of them say that is faraz. But for academic purpose, Hanafi and Hanbali says that is shart. Maliki and Shafi says that is rukun. Shart is something which is outside the thing concerned or the practice concerned. And rukun, that is inside the practice concerned. Point number three, niyat is must in the beginning of prayer. Literal meaning of niyat is intention, and technically in Sharia, niyat is defined as the firm intention of worship for the sake of Allah. The firm intention of worship for the sake of Allah. Al-Hazmu ala al-ibadati lillahi azza wa jal. The firm intention of worship for the sake of Allah. Then Intention is the action of our heart. So intention is by heart. While being for the sake of Allah, while being for the sake of Allah means sincerity. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in a hadith. Hadith is very much known. We don't say mashhoor, because mashhoor technically, as we mentioned in usul hadith, mashhoor is something else. So sometimes mashhoor means used as a lugavi, and not istilahi. Because in istilahi and as a terminology, mashhoor is a hadith which is narrated at least by three narrators in every second stage. So that's called hadith in mashhoor. But sometimes there is a hadith, mostly Muslim knows it, and they use it in their talk and speech. So in the Malamar Biniyat, their part of hadith is known almost to 80% of Muslims. Yes? So that's why sometimes we use the word mashhoor, but mashhoor doesn't mean terminological. Yes? Or technically, literally mashhoor. Literally mashhoor means mostly the people know it. Because that hadith is not mashhoor. Why? Because that is narrated in the time of Sahaba only by Umar ibn Khattab, radiyallahu ta'ala an. Later on, it is narrated by many, many narrators. But in the stage of Sahaba, that is narrated only by Umar ibn Khattab, radiyallahu ta'ala an. So, in their hadith, it is said, إِنَّمَا الْأَعْمَالُ بِالنِّيَّاتِ. Actions are but with intention. Hadith is very lengthy hadith. So prayer without intention is void. You can call it exercise. Yes? Even though you are reading here, you are reciting here, but you don't have the intention of prayer. So prayer without intention is void. What intention means? For one who prays, it is to believe. Intends Allah's good pleasure. Believe in prayer and its performing. Specify the prayer. The number of its rakat. Intends infirad, INFIRAD. Infirad. Imamat, IMAMAT. Imamat. Or Iqtida, IQTIDA. So in brackets you can write, because a Muslim, he will pray either individually, that is called infirad. He will do imamat, that is called imamat. Or he will be standing behind an imam, that is called iqtida. Got it? Bracket close. And intends the takbir as well. And intend the takbir, Allahu Akbar, as well. Next point, conditions for intention. Number one, Islam. Because a non-Muslim, if he will make the intention for prayer, yes. So for non-Muslim, there is no prayer. So that's why Islam is a condition for what?
for the intention of prayer. Number one, Islam. Number two, maturity. Purposely we use the word maturity. We don't use the word of puberty to be an adult, attain the age of puberty, because before puberty, the Muslims, they pray. Our kids, they start praying when they are 7. Yes. But in 7 years of age, a kid is that much mature that he knows what I'm doing. You know what I'm saying? So that's why I use the word maturity. Islam, maturity, and to know what he intends. Then according to Hanafi, it is must to have the intention connected to Takbir. Without having any strange thing in between the intention and Takbir. Without having any strange thing between intention and Takbir. Note, a strange thing means something which has no relation with the prayer. Strange practice means something which has no relation with the prayer, like eating. Is eating a part of prayer? Drinking, etc. But making wudu or going to mosque, is not a strange action. That is related to prayer. Why we are making wudu? For prayer. Why we are walking, we are going to masjid? To pray. Got it? So these actions are not strange. So now look. You can write it in brackets. If somebody made intention of prayer, and then he started eating, he ate, and after eating, he said, Allahu Akbar. But at that time, after eating, he had no any intention of prayer. So his prayer is void. You know what I'm saying? He cannot base their prayer upon their intention which he had before eating. This is right. Because that is a hurdle in between intention and what? Takbir. Got it? But somebody made intention for prayer and then he drove all the way from his house to masjid. Yes. When he entered the masjid, he did not refresh his intention of prayer. And he said, Allahu Akbar. Yes, his prayer is okay. You should write it like this. Got it or not it? Purvej, you got it or not it? Yes. So where you were? Last night we missed you. Or let me say that you missed. What you were doing in your thought, you should give due priority to your own community. That is only entertainment. So, or if somebody, he made intention, and then he went to make his wudu, first he made intention that I am going to pray. And then what he did? He made wudu. And then started his prayer without refreshing his intention once again. But he said, Allahu Akbar. His prayer is okay. Because wudu is not a strange practice. That is what? Related to prayer. You should write it. Got it? But anyhow, This connection are to refresh his intention. Connection are to refresh his intention. That is recommended. He came all the way after intention from his house to masjid. So when he is starting prayer, he should refresh his intention. Allahu Akbar. That is recommended. Same is the case for Hajj and Zakat. Look, somebody, when he was going out of his house to perform Hajj, so with the intention of Hajj, he went out of his house. With the intention of Hajj, he went out of his home. But where he was making his ihram, where he was making or putting on his ihram, he never refreshed his intention. He never refreshed his intention. So that first intention which he made when he was going out of his house, that is okay according to Abu Hanifa. You should write it. Same is the case of zakat. Separating the zakat part of wealth, intention at that time is must, not at the time of payment. You know that thing? And you collect it. How much? Yes. And you separated that portion with the intention of what? With the intention of zakat. Now, when you are taking out that money and giving it to poor and needy, at that time, you never refresh your intention of payment for God. Got it? So that first intention is okay. Next point. Intention after starting or after doing, that is not okay. You started your prayer without intention. And then after that, you started recitation, Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim, Malik Yawmiddin. And then you said, oh, my intention is to pray Nafl. It means nothing. You are a joke. Got it? And same is the case of zakat. You gave some money to Brother Musa. Yes. Even though he's a rich man. But anyhow, you gave some money to Brother Musa, and he was eligible for zakat. Yes. But when you gave money, later on you made the intention of zakat. Oh, let that money to be in zakat. That is not zakat. You should write it. Because prior intention is must for ibadat. What? Prior intention is must for ibadat. That's why we say that if somebody owes you money, you have given him loan. You have given him loan. And he is a poor man, he is unable to repay it back. Yes. And you want to help him with your zakat money. So you cannot say to him, the $1,000 which I have given you as loan, just consider it as zakat for you. No, it will never work. It will never work, because intention for the payment of zakat must be prior to payment. Must be prior to payment. So what you will do in this regard? You will give him $1,000, because this is zakat, and you are eligible. Then he will take it. It went to his possession and to his ownership. Now that is his property. You have nothing to do. Your zakat is paid. Just ask him, but you owe me $1,000. Yes. So your job is done and his is done. That's good. Do it like this. Got it? But you cannot say just count it in zakat. Count will never work, because prior intention is must. You wrote it or not it? You write it. That's an extra. Not related to the chapter. As an example, The only exceptional case, that is fasting. That in fasting, your later intention will work. As you know, that fast starts with dawn break. When fast is starting? With dawn break. So you had no intention to do fasting. But you couldn't eat anything since dawn break up to 11 o'clock, or as the case may be, 10 o'clock, 11 o'clock. You never ate or drank anything. And you said, oh, almost half of the day is gone. Let's make this day as fasting. And 10, 11 o'clock, you made the intention of fasting that is done. You should write it. Because there is the practice of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. At some time, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did not eat or drink anything. He came to his house 10, 11 o'clock and he asked Aisha, Hal fi dari shay'un li yukal? Is there anything to eat? Is there anything to eat? And Mother Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha, she said, no, we don't have anything. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, فَإِنِّي صَائِمٌ. So then I am with fasting. And there is nothing to eat, so then I am with fasting. Got it or not it? Yes. Yes, what a life of the Messenger of Allah. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَإِنِّي صَائِمٌ. So I am with fasting. Got it or not it? Yes. Or another example is that you had a fasting deal, means sada, a fasting deal, sada. You did not eat anything since dawn break up to 10, 11 o'clock. And you said, oh, half of the day is I have one day fasting. It is due on me. I have to do it. Okay, let's do it. Done. Even though you never made any intention prior to dawn break, you made it right in the middle of the action, which you have not started with the action of fasting. Yes? God is about it. So the later intention is worse in fasting. The Hanbalite said, connection of intention to takbir is the best, like Hanafi. Connection of intention to takbir, that is best. But if he made it a little before takbir, then he has not dissolved it. Nor he denounced Islam. May Allah forgive and forbid, may Allah forgive and forbid, may Allah forgive and forbid. Then that is okay with him. Then that is okay with him. Look, he never dissolved his intention. Yes, my intention was, I have to pray Ishraq. I have to pray Ishraq. Yes, my intention, I was sitting here, I have to pray Ishraq. After 10, 15, 20, 30 minutes, whatever the case may be, I never refreshed my intention. But I never dissolved my intention as well. Therefore, I'm not going to pray because I have to leave. I'm getting late. You know, if you say, oh, I have to leave, I'm getting late. That's a resolution to your intention. You dissolve it. Now, if you want to pray, so then you have to refresh your intention. But you never dissolved it. And now the person concerned, not you. Inshallah, you will be dying as Muslim. وَلَا تَمُوتُنَّ إِلَّا وَأَنْتُمْ مُسْلِمُونَ. Inshallah, we will have all that in form of say Islam. Inshallah. And our last word at the time of death will be لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ مُحَمَّدُ رَسُولُ. The Prophet ﷺ used to make a dua, اللَّهُمَّ جَعَلْ آخِرَ كَلَامِنَا لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ مُحَمَّدُ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ. Oh Allah, make last of words of our
لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله. What a lucky person is when every time after death he refreshes his contact with Allah. لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله. إن شاء الله you'll be dying like this. That's a beautiful death. Yes. That's what type of death? That's beautiful death. So death will come for sure. But we need a beautiful death. Marge har yak ete sar hamrangi ho. Deshi dushman dushmano pa dosto. The death of everyone will come to him as he is towards death. If he was a friend of death, death will come to him as a friend. If he was an enemy of death, death will attach him like an enemy. Yes. Our national poet Allama says, Kimmargi, har yak ete sar hamrangi o, deshi dushman dushman o pa dosto. Death of everybody is him, just like as he was towards death. If he was a friend of death, means making preparation. Making what? وَلَا تَمُوتُنَّ إِلَّا وَأَنْتُمْ مُسْلِمُونَ means be prepared for death anytime. Be ready for death anytime. We are ready for life every time. Yes, and our chef sometimes he used to make a joke. He said that our case is totally different. Neither we are ready for life nor for death. Yes, Brother Umar, our chef used to say that we are neither ready for life. It's not the way to live. Yes, nor we are ready for death. ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا سبحان الله. So neither he dissolved or broke his intention, nor he denounced the Islam. Nor he denounced Islam. If somebody made the intention of prayer, and then after that intention, he denounced Islam. Later on, once again, he denounced Islam. So based upon that intention which he made before denouncing, he cannot pray. He has to refresh his intention. Because actually he had demolished the first building. He had demolished the first building. Got it? Got it or not? Yes. The Malikite said, it is wajib to have the intention connected to takbir or a little while before it. Same is the case of Shafi. So now look, according to Imam Malik and Imam Shafi, if somebody made the intention of prayer, and then he walked to wudu area to make wudu. So he made wudu, and then he came out of that area into the masjid to pray the same prayer he made intention far before wudu. Before wudu, based upon that intention he cannot pray. He has to refresh it. He has to refresh it according to Imam Malik and Imam Shafi. You know what I'm saying? Because they say connection to takbir, connection of intention to takbir, that is must. You wrote it? And if somebody says, as I will mention, that to speak out the words of intention, what is it saying? Yes? So if somebody will say, I intended to pray Zuhr, Allahu Akbar, I intended to pray Zuhr. Look, I intended to pray Zuhr, Allahu Akbar, I intended to pray Zuhr. His salat is broken. His prayer is broken. Because the second I intended to pray Zuhr, that is speech of common layman. Or that is a normal speech of a human. You know what I'm saying? And he spoke that word after that he already entered into prayer. With Allahu Akbar, when you say Allahu Akbar, it means that now you are in prayer. So after that, if you will speak out a word, it will break your prayer. I intended to pray Zuhr, that word. So when you said, I intended to pray Zuhr, Allahu Akbar, I intended to praise Allah. So your prayer is broken. You are exercising now. Yes, if you will ask a Mufti later on, that I did like this, I intended to praise for Allahu Akbar, I intended. So the second, I intended, that's your kalam, that's your word. It broke your prayer. It broke your prayer if you write it. To express the intention by tongue, as we say, that the intention is by heart. Intention is what? By heart. So to express the intention by tongue, that is recommended according to Abu Hanifa, Shafi and Ahmad, and permissible according to Imam Malik. So for recommendation there is reward. For permissibility, there is no punishment, no reward. Got it? So Abu Hanifa, Shafi and Ahmad said, that is recommended to express by what? By tongue. Got it? Another point. In all schools, there is must to specify the prayer. To specify the prayer. Why? Because the time of a prayer concerned, the time of a prayer concerned includes or accommodate, not include, it can accommodate other types of prayer as well. Like the time of Zohar start 1 o'clock and it goes, for example, up to 5 o'clock. So in these 4 hours, you can pray only Zohar, or you can pray Zohar, you can pray Nafal, you can pray your Qaza, you can pray your Salat-e-Janaza. So that's why that is must to specify your prayer, that what type of prayer you are praying. Got it? So this is must in all schools to specify the prayer. Specification, that now I am praying my Sunnah. Now I am praying my Farz. Now I am praying Nafal. Now I am praying my Qaza. Now I am praying the Nazar of the pledge that I have given to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You know what I'm saying? So specification of prayer is must according to, you cannot say, yes, I intend to pray 4 rakat for the sake of Allah facing Allahu Akbar. You pray 4 rakat, oh, my Farz is done. No! Your Farz is not done. You have never intended to pray for us. You are praying prayer. That prayer could be Farz, it could be wajib, and can be Sunnah or Nafl, as the case may be. So what you will say? At least you will say, I intended to pray the Farz of Zohar, or the Farz of this time, Zohar, or this time which is Zohar itself. So you will say, that the Farz of this time, Allah. Got it or not? Yes. If you have not mentioned the record, that is the point which is coming later on, that you did not say 4 rakats of Farz of Zohar. That is 4 rakats. When you mention that the Farz of Zohar, so that is how many rakats? Is there any difference in Farz of Zohar that according to some school of Europe, there's 2 and to some of them 3 or 4 are the case maybe? You know what I'm saying? So Farz of Zohar, specification of prayer. Sunnah of Zohar, specification of prayer. Got it? So you wrote it? To specify the prayer. The Hanafi said, specification is best generally. Generally means for every type of prayer you have to specify. This is Farz, this is Sunnah, this is Wajib, this is Nafal. But in case of Farz or Wajib prayer, it is must. For Farz and Wajib, you have to specify. For Farz and Wajib. Can you give me the example of Wajib prayer? Not only this, but there are so many others. Yes, Eden. Like Eden. Like what? like event. See prayer is also. What is it? Specification is best generally. But that is much in Farag and Wajib. So best generally, you have to specify every type of prayer. That I intended to pray 4 rakat nafal. The specification of nafal. 4 rakat sunnah. Got it? They say that that is recommended and best. But for Farag and Wajib, that is must to specify. Got it or not it? And same is the case in qaza prayer. To specify the day and time, that is must. To specify the day and the time. Now there is another fitna. And that is that the Salafis, they said that who missed the prayer, who missed lot of prayer, there is no any concept of qaza for such a guy. He can do istighfar only. He can do istighfar only. Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. So anyhow, so in qaza, that is must to specify the day and time. But in adha, that is not needed. Only time is enough. Only what? Time is enough. And for time, you can name it or you can say the present time. Yes, I intended to pray the Fajr of Zuhr because you are in Zuhr time. And you are practically in Zuhr, so you can say, I intended to pray the Zuhr of this time. So by this time, you mean what? Zuhr. Got it? In case of sunnah or nafal, specification is recommended. But it could be done with the intention of prayer only. Nafal and sunnah, you can pray with the intention of what? Prayer only. Without mentioning nafal or sunnah. Without mentioning nafal or sunnah. I intended to pray 4 rakat. Allahu Akbar. I intended to pray 4 rakat. In case of imam, the only extra intention for imam according to Abu Hanifa is if women are standing behind him, women are standing behind imam, so he is bound to make the intention of their imamah. He is bound. If we, the men, are standing behind him, he doesn't need to make the intention of anyone. Because if somebody is praying his only prayer, look, I started my individual prayer. Farad. Allahu Akbar. Yes. Infirad. Munfarid. Individual. And somebody came and he joined me as Muqtadi. Even though I did not intend any imamah. And now I have become imamah practically because somebody is following me. He is standing as Muqtadi behind me, one or two. You know what I'm saying? So that imamah is okay, even though I have never made the intention of imamah. Even though I have never made the intention of imamah. Automatically I have become imam because of the practice of these two guys who stood behind me. Got it? But if the women are standing behind me as my Muqtadi, then for me that is must to make their intention. And that is why. Because Muhazat, M-U-H-A-Z-A-T, Muhazat. What? Muhazat. Muhazat of a woman Then I will tell you. Muhazat of a woman in Jamaah. Break the prayer of those men who are standing beside her, to left or right, who are standing beside her, to left or right, are behind her, three people behind her, till the last end of the Sufuf, till the last end of Sufuf. Now look, this is Imamat. Yes, just think that I am a woman. Yes, why? That's not bad. Changes are taking place in this world. Got it? Now look, I am standing here behind the Imam. So a man who is standing to my right in this house and to my left, their prayer is broken. Three men behind me in this house, in the other house, in 100 sufuf. Behind me, three men. How many? Three men, their prayer is broken. Muhazat breaks the prayer according to Abu Hanifa, rahmatullahi alayhi. But look, if the Imam has not made the intention of woman, this is right here. If the Imam has not made the intention of woman prayer, so in original madhab of Abu Hanifa, their iqtida is not okay. Their prayer is not okay. Prayer is not done. If the Imam has not made their intention, so their prayer is not done. But other Hanafi scholars said, their prayer is done, but their muhazat does not break the prayer of those women standing beside her. You should write this. That their prayer is done, but their muhazat will not break the prayer of those who are standing beside or behind her. But original madhab is the first one. Original madhab is what? The first one. If he did not make the intention of woman prayer, their prayer is not done. Got it? And as I was mentioning yesterday, that sometimes some issues you have to drop. There is no way. There is al-amru idha dafa ittasaha. When the situation is tight, when the situation is tight, the rules are relaxed. Situation became tight, so rules got relaxed. Otherwise, as we mentioned that according to Ahmad ibn Hanbal, Shafi and Malik, rahimahumullah, touching of a woman, maybe your own mother, maybe your own mother, according to some of them, it will break your wudu. It will break mammasa imratan faliyatawadda. Mammasa imratan faliyatawadda. Whosoever will touch a woman, so he should renew his wudu. Got it or not it? But in haram, when we are there in haram, there is not touching, almost hugging. Yes, pushing and pulling. Here is a sister and to your right is a sister and to sometimes you push her and sometimes she pushes you. You know what I'm saying? A friend woman. You know what I'm saying? And in haram, the Imam, for sure he is making the intention of woman, not of woman. They are standing behind Imam. You know what I'm saying? God or not, and you are standing here. Here is a woman. Your front, here is a woman. Behind you, there is a woman. Everywhere there is a woman. You know, if you will apply the rules of all these Imams as far as the case of woman prayer is concerned, so no prayer is okay according to three Imams. Because of the touch of woman, wudu is broken. Yes. And no prayer is okay because of the muhazat of woman, according to Abu Hanifa. But as we say, that when the situation is tight, the rules are relaxed. That is an okay. That's haram. Yes, in Medina it doesn't work, but in Makkah it works. Yes. Okay. In Medina, it doesn't work. Yes. But in Makkah, it works. The rules are relaxed. God is an artist. Yes. So why you did not write it? you are feeling cold? Later in Kalwa City, we are back to court. Got it or not?
And if someone is a muqtadi,
so now look, for munfarid, for what? Munfarid is an individual who is praying.
For munfarid, that is man must to specify his prayer and the time of prayer.
Yes.
For imam, the same is the case, to specify the prayer and the time of prayer.
Yes.
But is it must for imam to make the intention of imamat? According to Abu Hanifa, only in one case when women are standing behind him.
Only in one case, that is must for imam to make the intention of imamat, when
woman, if only men are standing behind him, he does not need to make the intention of imamah.
That imamat is okay without intention. That imamat is okay
without intention. Not according to others. That's according to Abu Hanifa, rahmatullahi alayh.
Yes.
Now, the third case is the case of a muqtadi who is standing behind imam. So for him, that is must to specify his prayer and the time of prayer.
Specify his prayer
and the time of prayer. And to specify his iqtida as well.
To specify his iqtida.
Specify his iqtida means that I intended to pray farz of zuhur behind this imam. Specify the Islami behind this imam.
What?
Behind this imam. If he did not make it, his prayer is not okay. Because one can pray individually as well.
Yes?
You are standing in the same stuff. We are standing in the same. So some people, they are busy in their farz, and some other, they are still praying their sunnah. Yes? Some other, they are praying their sunnah. So their prayer is totally different. You know, and so that's why that is must for a muqtadi to make intention of what? Iqtida. Make the intention of what? Iqtida, I-Q-T-I-D-A. Iqtida means to follow. Iqtida means to follow. Muqtadi is one who follows an imam. Near Imam Malik. Specification is needed in farz, witr, idain, kusuf, K-U-S-U-F, kusuf, khusuf, K-H-U-S-U-F. Khusuf and khusuf. Khusuf is sun eclipse and khusuf is a moon eclipse. For that, prayer is recommended. In khusuf and khusuf time, prayer is recommended. And why prayer is recommended? Because that's what we can say, a big event.
Yes.
Sun eclipse and moon eclipse. In heavenly system, that's a big event. Yes? And to pray through prayer, actually you are magnifying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How great Allah is. Look, He is controlling all this heavenly system. He is controlling all this heavenly system. So let's pray to God. Allah. That's for the greatness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Got it? Got it or not it? Sometime back when we were small kids, so generally the people used to say, oh, it means the sun is in difficulty or the moon is in difficulty, so we have to pray. Yes. You know what I'm saying? No, we are in difficulty. They are not in difficulty. In the Shamsa wal Qamara ayatani min ayatillah, la tankatifani bi mawti ahadin, wala li ayat hayati ahad. On the day
when Ibrahim ibn Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the 9-month-old son of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and at that time Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was 61 plus. His age was 61 plus. So when he passed away, yes, so this was the day that when the sun got eclipsed. So Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he delivered a speech. And he said, "Inna shamsa wal qamara ayatan min ayatillah." Because the time was very much close to the time of ignorance. And people were believing in heavenly bodies in such a way that all changes are coming because of heavenly bodies. You know what I'm saying? Ilmi Najum or astrology. Or what? Astrology. So Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he fixed them or he corrected them. So you may not believe in a wrong way. Yes? Because many people will say, "Oh, look at the sun. He joined in this sad occasion Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam." Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is said, "Because of the death of his son." Same is the case of S-U-N. Yes, son because of son. So Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, "Inna shamsa wal qamara ayatani min ayatillah." These are two big signs from amongst the signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It except does not take place because of the sadness of someone. Neither because of the death of someone, nor because of the life of someone. إِنَّ الْكَمَرَ وَالشَّمْسَ عَيَتَانِ مِنْ عَيَاتِ اللَّهِ لَا تَنْكَفِقَانِ لِمَوْتِ أَحَدٍ وَلَا لِحَيَاتِ أَحَدٍ رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم says that it happened, yes, just magnify Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and pray to rakat. Got it or not? So that's called khusuf and kusuf. Khusuf with K, that is sun eclipse. Khusuf with KH, that is moon eclipse. And istisqa, I-S-T-I-S-Q-A, istisqa. Istisqa means prayer for asking rain. Later on we will talk and we will approach that chapter, that in istisqa, the prayer is sunnah or not. So that is sunnah according to Imam Malik, Imam Shafi and Ahmad. And that is permissible according to Abu Hanifa, not sunnah. Because sometimes Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did pray and sometimes he made dua only. He went out and he made dua for rain only without prayer. Yes? And sometimes he did imamat and sometimes he prayed individually. Yes? But according to three imams, yes, prayer of two rakat istisqa with imama and jama'ah, that is sunnah. That is sunnah. Abu Hanifa rahimahullah says that you can say that prayer is recommended. Neither jama'ah is sunnah nor prayer is sunnah. In istisqa, you can make a dua without prayer. You can make a dua without prayer. But that is recommended to pray individually. To pray what? Individually. But anyhow, according to Imam Malik, that is sunnah. That is sunnah. And to tell you that look, without witr of Imam Malik, rahmatullahi alayhi, he said, that any sunnah which has a sabab, you should write it. Any sunnah which has a cause and reason for it. Which has a cause and reason for it. Specification is needed there. Specification is needed there. So this is the reason why we pray. Because we pray. Why we pray? Because of rain. It is a sabab. That's the reason. So wherever there is an Islamic reason for any type of sunnah prayer, there the specification of that prayer is must. So when you will make intention, you will say, "I intended to pray two rakat salati khusuf, two rakat salati khusuf, two rakat salati istisqa." Two rakat salati istisqa. Got it? And then he applied it to sunnah of fajr. He says that sunnah of fajr is not sunnah like other sunnah, like sunnah of zuhr, or sunnah of isha, or sunnah of maghrib. We pray two sunnah after isha first. Yes? Two sunnah after maghrib first. Four sunnah before zuhr first and two after zuhr first. But that sunnah, according to Imam Malik, you can pray with the intention of mutlaq prayer. I intended to pray four rakat for the sake of Allah. Allah. And that is considered sunnah. For those places over time, and you pray four rakat without mentioning that four rakat sunnah muakkad for the sake of Allah. You did not mention sunnah muakkad, four rakat
Body taken for love. Allah Akbar.
Got it? Your sunnah is done. Your sunnah is done. But in Fajr prayer, if you will say that I intended to pray two rakat,
Allahu Akbar, body taken for love, faith and qibla,
Allahu Akbar. Your sunnah of Fajr is not done. Because sunnah of Fajr is the akad of sunan, according to all four schools of jurisprudence. Akad of sunan, A-A-K-A-D-U-S-S-U-N-A-N. Akad of sunan, extraordinarily recommended. It is not muakkad like date of Zuhr, muakkad like date of Maghrib and Isha, more than that. That is more than that. Less than wajib, but more than muakkad. Less than wajib, but more than what? Got it or not it? So that's why he said, that for other sunnahs you can pray without mentioning the word sunnah. That is the time of Zuhr and you intended, I intended to pray four rakat for the sake of Allah. Allahu Akbar. Your four rakat sunnah of Zuhr is done. Got it? But in Fajr, according to Imam Malik, you have to mention sunnah. Two rakat sunnah of Fajr. Allahu Akbar. Got it? Then, Ada and Qada. Ada, when you pray in time. Qada, when you miss and later on you are making it. Ada and Qada, both could be prayed with the intention of each other. Knowing the meaning of Ada and Qada is interchangeable. Knowing the meaning of Ada and Qada is interchangeable. In Arabic, sometimes you pray your Salat al-Fajr. Alhamdulillah, we prayed our Salat al-Fajr. We prayed our Salat al-Fajr. So you can say, Addaytu Salat al-Fajr. Ada, Addaytu Salat al-Fajr. And you can use in Arabic, Qadaytu Salat al-Fajr. Qadaytu, from Qada. So Qada is in the meaning of Ada. Qada is in the meaning of Ada. Somebody missed his Isha prayer last night. And now he made it. Last night he missed it. And now he made it. So he can use the word Qadaytu Salat al-Isha. I made the Qada of Salat al-Isha. I made the Qada of Salat. And he can say Addaytu Salat al-Isha. I prayed Salat al-Isha. Yes. So it means that the word Ada and Qada, meaning wise that is interchangeable. Meaning wise that is interchangeable. So look, if somebody he was making his qada, but he used in intention the word ada. He used the intention of word or kalima ada. So his qada is done. Or he was praying ada, but he used the word qada. So his prayer is done. You should write it. Because these words in Arabic language are interchangeable. But he must know that they're interchangeable. He must know. It's the sense of interchange. If he does not know, then his prayer is not okay. You should write it. He doesn't know that Ada is in the meaning of Qada or Qada is in the meaning of Ada. Got it or not it? If someone joined an imam on Friday, with the intention of Friday prayer, with the intention of Friday prayer, but afterward he came to know that it was Zuhr. Here the Jamaha was taking place for what? For Zuhr. You mean you are, look at me, you are traveling somewhere. You are traveling somewhere, passing by a small mosque, and there the people already started prayer. And that was Friday Zuhr time. And you joined the imam with the intention of Friday prayer. That this is Friday and they are praying what? Friday prayer. So you joined them with the intention of Friday. You know what I mean? But later on you came to know that they were not praying Juma. They were not praying Juma because certain conditions are there for Friday prayer. There are certain conditions. In this regard we do follow Imam Muhammad and Abu Yusuf. Otherwise according to Abu Hanifa, we cannot pray Juma here in America. He's very strict in this regard. You know what I'm saying? That Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says that لا تصلى الجمعة إلا في مسجد. لا تصلى الجمعة
إلا في مصر.
Yes.
Only in Cairo, behind Hosni Mubarak, you can pray. Prophet ﷺ says, Jummah could not be prayed but only in Misr.
Yes.
And Misr being a big city. Misr means a big city. And for a big city, there is a definition in Lugha. For a big city, there is a definition in Lugha and definition in Fiqh. Definition in Lugha. Lugha means, say, dictionary. And Fiqh means laws, Islamic Sharia. So, definition in Lugha for a big city or for Misr is where every need and necessity of human life is available. Where every need and necessity of life is available. And where a proper administration is working. That's definition of Misr. Number one, administration is there. And number two, every need and necessity of life is available. So, literally this is called what? Misr. But Islamically, where the laws of Islam are implemented.
Yes,
the fuqaha. They say that Misr in Sharia doesn't mean there. He said, yes, where the animals are living, so we have nothing to do with that. That's just like a forest. It's just like a jungle. Yes, where the law of Islam are implemented. Where the laws? Islam are implemented practically or could be implemented if they want. Could be implemented. We call it bilfail or bilquwa. Umar. We call it what? Implementation bilfail? Al bilquwa. Implementation bilfail means practically it is working. That laws of Quran or Sunnah are implemented there. Yes. Or they can implement it because they have the authority. The Muslim. And they can implement the rules of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They can implement the rules of Sharia, but they don't want. For example, in Misr, if Hosni Mubarak wants, he cannot implement the rules of Allah. He can't. He has implemented his dictatorship, so he cannot implement the rule of Allah. So in all these Muslim countries, they cannot implement the rule of Allah. See, they can. So it means implementation practically is not there, but bilquwa, that is. Bilquwa, that is. Abu Hanifa, rahimahullah, in Islamic Sharia, our Hanafi school of thought, they define the Misr, or the big city, where the law of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are implemented practically or could be implemented. But we are living in America. Can we implement the laws of Allah? No, we cannot. We are not in authority. You know what I'm saying? God is not it. So that's why we are following Abu Yusuf and Imam Muhammad. Otherwise, we Hanafis are free from Jummah. Yes, just try your door and go out. There is no Jummah. You know what I'm saying? There's not only a matter of gathering. There are certain requirements when we'll go to that chapter, so we will talk in detail. Yes. What are the conditions or prerequisites of Salat Jummah? Yes. Who is bound to pray Salat Jummah? And where? And how? Yes. Who? Where? How? www.com. Yes, sir. So for Friday, you have to go to website www.h. Here is www. There is www.h. Just look. So it means they have taken idea from Abu Hanifa. Yahoo. So Yahoo belongs to Abu Hanifa then. Anyhow. So further detail, inshallah, this is just a very technical chapter. Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen, wa salatu wa salamu ala Rasooli Muhammad wa alihi wa sahbihi 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 wa alihi wa sahbihi